delighted to see you here this morning. If this is your first time with us, please make sure that you see someone with a name tag so that you can receive your welcome gift from us. As you experience our service today, you will discover, if you're brand new, that there are several elements that are quite different from other traditional church settings. We use popular music instead of church music, and we use popular movie clips in a rather unique way. Our approach is designed to encourage each one of us to find the spiritual in the everyday. Please refer to your program so that you can see the week's announcements, and we also ask that you fill out the blue card on your table. That is our connection card. That allows us to get important information to you. And finally, the blue baskets that are on the table are there for your contribution to our faith community. Today's service focuses on the connection between mind, body, and spirit. The phrase mind-body-spirit connection has been used more and more frequently in our everyday language. So we're going to take a few minutes and talk about what does that phrase actually mean. Let's look at those terms individually and then see how they interrelate. Let's start with body because that's the easiest. We all have a body. It's our physical structure, the vessels, the vessel that holds our brains, our body parts, our muscle and our fat. Our body consists of roughly 50 trillion cells, which collectively organizes our tissues, our nerves, our bones, and our organs into our outward physical appearance. Our mind governs our mental and emotional aspects. Our mind allows us to be aware of the world, and it powers our ability to think and to feel. Our spirit is a little bit more complicated. Our spirit is invisible to us and to others. Its eternal nature doesn't need a physical body. It doesn't need to conform to space or time. Instead, it is the expression of life's creator. However you choose to define that creation of life, a divinity, a source, God, or the universe. We express through this creator our creative expressions, each and every one of us. We are an immortal being in our spirit. Our spirit can connect us to something much bigger outside of ourselves. It connects us to our five senses. So how do these three individual parts of us get connected to each other? And more importantly, how does that connectiveness impact our lives? Well, while mind, body, and spirit might seem to be separate, they are actually intimately connected and completely reliant upon each other. When they are integrated, they complete our unique human essence. The interconnectedness of our mind, body, and spirit means that whatever we experience in one part, we experience in all three parts of us. When we experience disease or injury in our body, our mind and spirit are also affected. When negative thoughts or fears occur in our mind, our body and spirit also feel stressed or off balance. When our connection to spirit is frail, we may turn to our mind and body to try to find the answers as to why we're feeling disconnected. The truth is that all three aspects are always listening to us, always aware of everything that's happening. Our mind, body, and spirit are always present in each and every single thing we do, think, consume, and say. Because our three parts are interconnected, every problem we face must involve all three. And this process, which we call integration, is holistic. It's a returning to the original natural harmony between our mind, body, and spirit. with a holistic approach, we are always feeling a little bit off, like something is missing without this holistic approach. We feel out of balance when one thing is askew because it echoes in the other two things. Many of us are affected by how we handle stress in our life. If chronic stress is left unchecked, we know that it will take a toll on our bodies. However, a strong spirit, a strong faith, can help us to cope with the stress that we experience in our life, and it can enable the impact of that stress to feel less significant. I have chosen to focus on this topic this morning because I believe that this recognition of the interrelationship between mind, body, and spirit is not only incredibly important, but I think that the relationship and the efforts to maintain wellness within our mind, body, and spirit is actually life-saving. It gets us through the storms of life.
This is where the walls gave way. This is demolition day. All the debris and all the dust, what is left of what was once, sorting through what goes and what should stay. Every stone I did for you, as if you would ask me to. Thank you.
hope. The truth of this statement was never more apparent to me than this past week. My son Jeremy was laid off from his job in February, and for the past 8 months he's been just the picture of discipline and perseverance. Exercising and networking and researching and reading and interviewing. He was relentless in his search while trying to keep his life in balance. Everything came together for him this past week. He got 2 job offers. He found a new apartment. He passed his PMP certification. And he's launched a new career. He never lost hope. Please pray with me. God, our lives are constantly changing. We can be sailing along smoothly and one day wake up to a new reality. Something has thrown us off course. It's sometimes sudden and it's sometimes gradual, but the end result is always the same. We need to right the ship. At these times, we need your help to see through the fog. We need a nudge to center ourselves spiritually, emotionally, and physically. Give us hope. Help us to remember that when there is a storm, the clouds always part eventually, and sunshine follows soon after. Thank you, God. Amen.
You're not alone, together we stand. Be by your side, you know I'll take your hand. When it gets cold, feels like the end. There's no place to go, you know I won't give in. No, I won't give in.
Tiger, but we have all been in those tough spots, those difficult seasons in our life, and sad to say, as you all know, we will go through them again and again. It's just part of life. We fare best when we are going through those difficult times, when we are balanced in our mind, body, and spirit. An athlete doesn't wait until the night before tryouts to try to start learning how to play the game. An actor doesn't wait until right before opening night to learn his lines. Practice has been taking place. Strengthening has been taking place. We need to keep our minds and our bodies and our spirits tended and practiced and fed, and the relationship between them as balanced as possible, so that when that sudden, surprising, challenging lifeboat moment arrives, we have some resources to fall back on. If we wait until we're stranded out in the middle of the ocean all by ourselves and then try to find something bigger than ourselves to believe in, wish that we had some faith, we're coming pretty late to the party. So how will we know if we're doing a good job of balancing these elements? How will we know if we're healthy in our mind, body, and spirit? Well, according to a beautiful article entitled Wellness, written by Dr. Brian Seward, there are some clear identifying markers of well-being, of wellness, in each of the three parts of our being that we can pay attention to. Physical wellness is, of course, the easiest to identify because our bodies are tangible and measurable. We are physically well when our body's systems are working optimally. And there are tests that can be run, as we all know, to determine our wellness level of our body. Measuring our mental wellness is much more difficult. Our mental well-being is understood to be the ability to gather, process, recall, and communicate information. Also part of the wellness of our minds lies in our emotional well-being. And emotional well-being is best defined as the ability to feel and express the entire range of human emotions, from anger to love, and to control them, not be controlled by them. Our spiritual well-being is defined by the maturity of our higher consciousness, and that can happen at any age. Young Pai was spiritually mature. His higher consciousness was alerted to the existence of what he wanted to believe in at a very young age. And this maturity of our higher consciousness and our spiritual well-being is measured and observable by the way we interact in our relationships, by our own personal value system, and whether or not we have discovered for ourselves a meaningful purpose in life. So we know how to exercise our bodies. We know that we should walk and we should lift weights and we should do all those things, and we know how to kind of exercise our mind. We know we need to find connections with other people, and we need to take breaks from time to time to give our minds a rest. But how, you might be asking, how do we strengthen and exercise our spirit? Well, I think we work out our spirit just like we work out our body and give our minds a rest. And since our spirit gives us meaning and purpose, and our spirit enables us to love one another, then we practice that. We practice loving one another, even when it's hard. That's spiritual exercise. Our spirit gives us intuition to understand the difference between right and wrong, and so we exercise that to intuition. We don't ignore it. We don't pretend like we don't know the difference. We act on it, we think about it, we consider it, we take time to figure out what our own personal value system is. We don't ignore the big questions in life. We actively pursue a meaningful purpose for our life. We work out our spiritual muscles just like we work out our body and our mind. Author Leo Buscaglia has written, "The fact that I can plant a seed and it becomes a flower, share a bit of knowledge and it becomes another's, smile at someone and receive a smile in return, are to me continual spiritual exercises." I challenge each of us to seek balance in that beautiful, beautiful connectedness between our mind and our body and our spirit. Let's keep ourselves fit and balanced so that we will be better equipped the next time we are in the middle of a storm. Amen.
We dreamers have our ways of facing rainy days, and somehow we survive. We keep the feelings warm, protect them from the storm, until our time arrives. Then one day the sun appears, and we come shining through those lonely years. I made it through the rain, I kept my world protected. I made it my point of view, I made it through the rain, I found myself respected by the others who got rained on.
This morning is that we will strive for this state of harmony so that we can live well and be prepared for the storms. Have a great Sunday and go in peace. Amen.